What's up, guys? So I bought the Nioh probably a couple months ago. I know it's an older game, as you see it's 2017. But decided I wanted to try it out. I heard it's kind of like the Dark Souls style game. So I'm not sure what to really expect other than lots of pain and agony. But I'm pretty much going through it blind. I have no idea what anything is. And hopefully I don't die too much. To the far east lies Xingpagu, a land brimming with golden palaces and sparkling jewels. Kublai Khan, ruler of the Mongol Empire, sent a large army there. But the warriors of Xingpagu used miraculous stones to put up a strong defense. The travels of Marco Polo. Crystals. I guess these are the strange stones.
Some call it a miraculous stone. A philosopher's stone.
Stone turn red. Red with blood, probably. That's the symbolism there. Tower of London is an opposing fortress built by King William I in order to keep London safe. It has long since gone on to be used as a prison for traitors and execution grounds for criminals. Londoners believe that if the many crows living within its walls were to abandon it, the tower would collapse and London itself would be destroyed. Death comes for you.
It seems death won't stop chasing me.
Tower of London, England. This way. Oh. Punching down walls and stuff.
I should have run when I had the chance.
So I don't know where I'm supposed to run, so I don't want to like run into this enemy. Maybe I'm supposed to kill that guy? I don't have any weapons though, so I don't know if I'm supposed to engage him or not. I'm definitely supposed to just run. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna run to the right then. Because he's patrolling left. You can see there's a gaping hole. You can hear me walk. Give me a weapon. Oh. Keep thinking, that is not. Okay, start with a simple bastard sword. Need some foot guards. Some boots. I think that's all I got. Some shortcuts. No items. This definitely looks like a Dark Souls style game. Oh yeah, it's like an always on game. Like you can't pause. Looks like. Stays menus back dash. And of course, I have the inputs and stuff as Xbox buttons, but I'm playing with the PS4 controller. All right, guard. It's time for you to die. Yeah.
What are you doing?
Killing you. That's what I'm doing. Ooh. Oh, okay. That's just the key. Don't need to go back in, but it's kind of funny. Oh. I kept thinking X is X is to like interact and grab stuff, but it's actually B or circle. There's blood on my sword. Poor bastards. What is the point of having two of the same weapon? I'm assuming not. So you do have two sets of shortcuts, one's in blue, one's in orange. So if you see right now it's orange shortcuts, but if I switch to the blue shortcuts. So up is heal, so I gotta be careful not to use it on accident. I'm just waiting for like traps and stuff. Lion guard. So the question is, am I Japanese or am I a Londoner? Snazzy. Kinda looks Chinese actually. Their embroidery style. Alright, well, combat time. Don't wait for me. Make sure you don't miss. That was a stone. Stone's gonna do probably to like throw enemies for huge damage. Oh, I didn't say huge damage, but it's just heal damage. See, don't just stand there. Get some. Fasten this. Oh. So I'm about to get myself killed. Medicine heals about 40. Got some pants. Where's some pants? Oh, I guess I already had pants. Or maybe I just picked them up from both of them, actually. Nice, nice. I'm still trying to get used to combat here. Looks like he automatically sheaths and whips out his sword if you do an action. Oh. Heal me. Nice. So those are healing stations, like altars. Equip that battle axe. I'm assuming it's a slower startup, but probably does more damage. Then this thing probably is a stabby stab. That's why there's no way of like. Well, there might be. Let's say it's like. Don't know if there's any treasure anywhere. Let's see if there's upstairs first. Before I go outside. More medicina. I wonder how much medicine I can do. That's the way forward. So let's actually go back. Go out this door. Oh. Looks like this is a shortcut back to this heal fountain. Should probably test this battle axe out real quick before I. Yeah, it's hella slow. It probably does like a buttload of damage. Yeah, let's stick with the faster weapon for now. Whoa. Next time, let's not get stabbed like that. Oh, I thought I could break that. Break these crates. Oh, are these better gloves? Look like the same. They are better. Better by quite a lot, actually. Oh, that's pretty cool. You can run, you like turn around like that. I don't think I've ever seen that before. I think it's because a lot of times turning around in these kind of 3D games is kind of awkward. So they probably added that to reduce awkwardness. Pretty sure that was dangerous the way I'm like fighting these guys. Oh, this is the shortcut I was talking about. Yep. Back to the healing fonts. So they haven't taught us how to spend, like... down. I was in there guarding without any HP. Or not HP, but stamina. So of course my guard got broken. These guys like respawn or something. Quick swipes.
Get stun locked.
I'm pretty sure he's gonna get to a point where I should be just swiping like that. Alright, so let's go back, or actually let's go down, let's see if there's anything down here. It's a treasure chest. Crows too. Probably get one guy by himself. Just this way. That's pretty cool though, it does keep into consideration the terrain, so you can hit the wall and it will mess up your hit. It like glance off the wall, kind of put you in a little stagger state. Alright, another bastard sword. I wonder if this one's better. It's definitely better. Wow, the battle axe is actually a lot more damage. Close combat being reduced. Change to attack strength. I see all these like little stats at the bottom. I'm kinda iffy about that. Ranged weapon. I wonder if your weapons can break. This guy like hears something behind him. It is I. Still don't know what this guy's name is actually. Unlocked the learned skills yet, so just gotta wait and see what that's all about. That's so dangerous. I think like the fourth hit becomes like this stab move or his thrust. And yeah, it's makes me miss a lot of times. I feel like that's the way out, so I'm gonna go explore this way. Ooh, I don't want to explore that way. Or do I? I'm a little scared, actually. He's like Zhao Yun from Dynasty Warriors. I mean, it's from the same company. see how far they'll chase me. Ouch. That was a really big whiff. You guys are elite. Elite soldiers. Whoa. I feel like a shadow. Ouch. Oh. So much damage. I'm gonna back myself into a corner. Not dead. He's dead now. Woohoo! Okay, cool. That was a little scary, to be honest. Those guys did massive damage. Alright. See what we got. Got a head, helm, plus 10 life, 3.8% damage reduction. Received firearms damage. Does that mean I gain, like, take more damage? That sucks. It's kind of weird. A lot of battle axes. Coat. Oh, very strong coat. Weaker gauntlets, so let's not use those. Way better trousers. And slightly better boots. Alright, there we go. So yeah, definitely fighting stronger enemies yield stronger loot for sure. Let's say. Lock on. This right thumbstick. Guard evade, change weapons, text menu, items. So yeah, sometimes I don't lock on, just because I kind of like the free roaming swipes that you can do. Because sometimes when you lock on, it kind of messes you up a little bit. At least it messes me up sometimes. Switch. Just walking around, hopefully find something. I was trying to attack him.
Using monsters like that to fight wars. Guess they got no more use for us. His body just split in two. He wanted to kill me from the start.
These are like torture devices.
Striking when the opponent is down and helpless. That's what they're trying to do to all of us who fought for queen and country.
It's good to know. I wonder if you have to learn that or do you have that unlocked already? I don't know what to expect though. Yeah, I think all those yellow orbs are experience orbs. Ouch. Spaced out. Yeah, it's really rough because if you're too close to something, you hit it, it might force you to bounce off of it. Ooh, 50. It's only slightly better, but ooh, this one's a lot better. I'm assuming you can probably sell this stuff for experience later. I think that one's stronger than the one I have too. Yes. 9. I'm not sure if I want to use a battle axe because it's so slow. It's better to have speed rather than strength a lot of times. Wow, we both missed each other. Back up. It's a boss. It's a boss. Defeated. Too easy. Of course, it's his first boss, but. Who are you?
It's you.
It's me.
With the guardian spirit.
Who are you? It's like a summoner of some sort, or necromancer.
If I die, the secret of the stones dies with me.
Let me show you what these stones can do.
He knows the secrets. Uh-oh. I think I'm about to...
It's time for your execution.
Yeah. Turn into a demon. Oh my lord. That's why this guy was so easy to beat. Ouch! I try to dodge. Yeah. How far back did I go? Can't say not too far, it's somewhat far. But I don't think I actually gain any experience right now. Might be mistaken. Oh, these guys are back. Oh shit. Oh crap. Keep trying to just step back. Crap. I'm so bad at this. Okay. I'm just trying to like sidestep it so he misses. But I need to straight up either dash back or block. Ooh. Ooh. Ouch. Too slow. The breastplate looks pretty good. breastplate. Yep, a lot better. Whoa! They came back. Oh. I guess I'll just fight him again. No big deal. Like stabby stab. Yes, by a little bit. There's so many like different stats that we can get. This actually has more toughness, it looks like, by a little bit. The defense multiplier. Weight. But yeah, of course the weight makes it slower, but that's the trade-off. Speed versus defense. Try this again. What you got? Block that too. You guys gotta slow down. Ah. Him. Spectral Blade. Nice.
Ooh, well done. Quite a
wonderful
feat.
You're next. No. What?
So this spirit shall guide me to the kingdom of gold.
Run. Okay. So you don't hesitate. so he gets shot. What did he pick up, though? Is that one of the, it's a feather from a crow, probably. Maybe it's her feather, actually. I did have armor, so it shouldn't have penetrated that hard, I don't think. Then again, arrows penetrate armor, so bullets can definitely penetrate armor. I don't know what I'm talking about. At the same time, though, I think bullets back then, you know, they're the round bullets, right? So they don't penetrate metal as good.
The journey was not an enjoyable one. During 2 years' voyage, the Hellof was lost. The Trow sank, while the Hope vanished without a trace. The good news of the Blider Boatshop was nothing but lies. Only Leifdar remained. An ironic twist. But what awaited us in the Far East wasn't love. It was monsters and death.
So I guess he was a Londoner. Englishman. Before I begin my preparations for landfall, I leave once more through that curious book I had chanced upon. Recorded inside are the memoirs of a sailor who had once paid visit to the land of Zimbaku. Precisely how this document wound up in the hold of the ship, when its author clearly belonged to a crew of a different boat, is beyond me. But here I am, poring over his pages all the time, or all the same. And not for the first time this voyage, I may add. What fascinated me above all else were the memoirs' many accounts of Zimbaku's diverse armor and weaponry. Or of Zimbaku's diverse armor and weaponry. Oh, so we get to choose. I kind of like the idea of dual swords, to be honest. Orochi samurai sword. Tafana is pretty nice. Body. Heart. I think I want to go with dual swords. I don't know what's the best, but dual swords seem to be calling out to me out of all of them. The sailor from the memoir seems to have spent elite time, or spent quite some time in Zimbaku, and succeeded in keeping the company of samurai. He writes in detail of establishments in Zimbaku called dojo, where people, including samurai, congregate for instruction in the martial disciplines. Just reading the sailor's vivid accounts, I feel as though I am there in the flesh, watching these warriors as they train. The samurai is master of many armaments, and trains for combat in every imaginable scenario. If I were to use another weapon, which one would I choose? Second weapon. Maybe something to balance out the probably short reach of the dual swords. So maybe this. Kusarigama. Because you don't want two short weapons. Orochi and axe are probably very slow. Spear wasn't too bad. Spear and sword weren't too bad. But I feel like this is like super long range. A weapon that combines a sickle and weighted chain. Mastery of this unusual weapon requires a deep understanding of many special techniques. The sickle allows for quick strikes and close range, and the chain and weight can be thrown to add range to the weapon's offensive repertoire. Axe. A weapon with a thick, heavy blade at one end. Its weight gives it a slow weapon to swing, but also gives it considerable power. Enemies find its attacks difficult to deflect. Oh, so it probably drains a lot of the enemy's stamina as well, if they block it. Spear. A long-handled weapon tipped with a blade. Its superior reach enables rangy sweeping attacks. However, it will ricochet wildly if struck against the wall, making it a poor weapon for closed spaces. I feel like this one's probably the best, like,
choice.
I do like the spear idea, though, but I think I'm gonna try this out. Mainly because, like, all these other weapons are pretty traditional, but this one is not. The memoir also asserts that the samurai are knowledgeable in the martial arts. First, they know which fighting stance to use in each situation, high, mid, or low. Second, after each attack, they ready themselves for the next strike by focusing their ki, or inner energy. Third, once their ki is readied, the samurai can use purification techniques to rid their surroundings of malevolence. I know not how to explain it, but I feel as though I have some innate ability to grasp all these concepts, and have experimented many times with each technique. The memoir states Zimbaku is home to 8 million gods or other deities. Exactly how this figure was derived, I can only imagine. But as I cast my gaze to the shore, I am struck by the sensation that some mystical power has been keeping watch over me. It is an energy that reminds me of Sarse. I pull out the memoir once more and survey each page until I arrive at the guardian spirit that best matches the force I am sensing. Fox, shark, or owl, or hawk. So it's like fire, fire, water, or grass. Good old Pokemon, I see. Let's see, so the wolf, a guardian spirit of the fire elemental, strengthens the attack power of those in its protection. A shark and guardian spirit of the water elemental amplifies the ability of those in its protection to sense enemies. A hawk and guardian spirit of the wind elemental, oh, I guess wind and not grass, increases the evasive abilities of those in its protection. So it's either damage, like ability to sense, or evasion. I feel like in this case, evasion might be the best. However, I'm using kind of fast, at least a double sword is like a fast weapon, and so I think strength might be best. I think sensing enemies is always, you know, a good thing. You like see things coming so you don't get that surprise, so this is like a balanced choice. Of course this one is just speed and dodging. Obviously you can only pick one, so it's gonna be between fire or evasion. At the same time, the sensing thing probably helps a lot. But the thing is, I think sensing is only good for like the first time around, because once you know where enemies are or like where they would be, then a lot of times you don't really need to know where they're going to be coming from. At least like you already know where they're gonna come from. But again, I think because my weapons are fast-paced or whatever, are lightweight, I think I should be okay with having enough stamina to like dodge out, so I might just go with straight strength for this particular playthrough. Nice. That's a pretty interesting way of setting up your character. Let's go. I should probably have hit okay, see if there's more dialogue, but I want to hit the tutorial mission. This dojo is a training ground for samurai. It is built with the blood, sweat, and tears of the uncounted warriors who polished their techniques within its walls. These long traditions and secrets are handed down from generation to generation of samurai. Maybe he's not an Englishman, I don't know. Let me get that. Oh. Wooden sword. Is it the double swords that I. Nope, it's the single. may proceed to the next tutorial. It's as if I didn't like learn how to do all this. Quick and strong. If your ki reaches zero, you will not be able to attack until it recovers. Oh, so instead of stamina, it's ki. The green, oh. Too easy. It's probably gonna teach me how to block, probably. Or not, lock on. Oh! It's next tutorial side. It is outside. Guard. Dodge or guard everything. Finish him.
Dang.
Stabbing him with the wooden sword. Switch stance. Oh, geez. High stance, mid stance, low stance. High stance emphasizes attack power. It allows for powerful techniques. Mid stance is good for defense. Has a wide range of techniques and is easy to use. Low stance is good for dodging. It doesn't consume much ki and also maintains your guard as you move. Jeez. Those stances are going to be pretty interesting. Wow, that's like hella fast. Quick strikes. Way too good, actually. I might be doing a lot of low stance in this fight, or in, like, in general. Next tutorial. Key pulse. Right button when blue lights gather around you after an attack. A key pulse recovers your key. The amount varies depending on your timing. The maximum amount is determined by your key gauge. Oh. Huh. Interesting. Another world born from the yokai. When you are in the yokai realm, your ki recovery is greatly reduced. Conversely, the powers of the yokai themselves are enhanced there. Purity recovers the maximum amount of ki from a successful ki pulse in the yokai realm. It also cleanses the defilement of the yokai realm from your person, restoring you to normal. Wooden axe. Oh, one of everything. Shoot, press RT while holding LT. Switch ammo. X or square for normal and Y or triangle for special. Click right stick to zoom. Ready weapon with LT and press RT to shoot. Use right stick to move the red keel. Switch between types by pressing square or triangle or X or Y, depending if you're Xbox or PS. Some enemies have a weak spot. Landing a hit on their weak spot will deal greater damage and break their stance. The middle of the reticule will turn red when pointing at an enemy's weak spot. The rest of the reticule will turn red the closer you are to an enemy. It's a lot of, spear stone. Use up all your Ametria, but allows you to quit a mission and return to the start. Oh, I see. So this is kind of like Hunter's Mark, I believe, in Bloodborne. A fragment of high density image Amrita that glows with a faint golden light as though it contains a firefly. Use it to receive Amrita, Hunter Amrita. Nice. Living weapons. When the Guardian Spirit Amrita gauge is full, press B and Y. Or circle and triangle. Guardian Spirit skill. While living weapon's active, press B and Y again. Triggering a living weapon changes the health gauge and key gauge into the living weapon gauge. As long as the living weapon gauge is active, you are impervious to damage, and your close combat inflict more damage. The living weapon gauge decreases over time, and when enemy attacks land, once the gauge is fully depleted, its effects wear off. While a living weapon is active, press B and Y will perform your Guardian Spirit's unique skill. It's like Musou attack. All the missions have been completed. Do we just quit out then? Oh. So, go forward. Nice. Not too bad. Very interesting game mechanics for sure. I'm not sure how I'm gonna be able to adapt to all this so much. Alright, close memoir. Let's start. Start the story. The dinghies have been readied for us to make landfall. For all I have read on this country, nothing can truly prepare me for what now lies ahead. I put the memoir down and leave my cabin. It's about to go down. Kuroshima is a tiny island off the coast of Usugi in Kyushu's Bungo province. There is little in the way of usable land, with coastline rapidly giving way to cliffs and mountains. Clinging to its edge is the smallest of fishing villages, its residents eking out subsistence farming on plots carved out from the hills. Their frugal lives stand in stark contrast to the village elder, whose opulent mansion perches atop the island's tallest peak, strangely oversized for the small island which it overlooks. So what happened to all your armor, man? Uh-oh. Vita. Ooh, those are like spiritual little larvae. Skill points obtained. Press the status menu via menu button to learn new skills. They just took away all my weapons. Yes, they did. Learn skills. Grapple. Samurai skill points. Grapples an enemy who is out of key, then follows up with a powerful attack. Purify Yokai Realm. I think I already have this unlocked. Yes, yeah, I had a key pulse within the area. Changing to another stance on a successful key pulse increases the amount of key recovered. Mid low stance only, follows up a combo with a kick, then causes a large amount of key damage. I feel like I should grab this. Let's grab command Y for opponent out of key. Yeah. Don't know if I want this quite yet. Changing to another stance on a successful key pulse increases the amount of key recovered. Pronounce EI. Oh yeah. EI, quick draw. I see. I love how they tell us how to pronounce it. Yeah, let's just wait, because I don't know if I really want this quite yet. Alright, so I have no weapons yet. For whatever reason. Speaking of weapons, looks like they gave me the double swords that I wished for. Yeah. Oh, here's a, pretty cute, actually. Oh. Oh, I can actually change Guardian Spirits. Nice. It's only have 150 Amrita. Probably for picking up that item just now. If thou wishes for divine protection, visit the shrine and say a prayer. I would, but I don't have any Amrita. Well, let's see if there's anything else besides leveling up. Make an offering to receive Amrita. Oh, this is like selling, right? Yeah, this is like selling. What are you selling? Oh, DLC. I probably have them. Oh, nice, I do. I don't know. Dharma Chakra Kabuto? I'm not sure what that is. Is that free items? That's free helmets. I don't care. Let's go ahead and take it. Ooh, elixir. Restores health when used. Said to be made by Kodama's tree spirits from nuts and seeds, but the truth is unknown. It only affects those with spiritual strength. Connoisseur savor its unusual bitter flavor. Oh, I can probably go ahead and use one. Let me get that. I wonder if that's enough to upgrade something. This is 100, yes, I should be able to. Does it tell us what each of these do? Affects, so body affects life and resistance to poison and paralysis. It definitely helps viewers. Heart affects ki. So heart gives you more of the green gauge, which in this game it's stamina. So there's like a separate one for stamina. Affects life and how much weight you can carry. Oh, that's interesting. Strength. Oh, actually, stamina affects cannons. Huh. Strength. Amount required to activate the special effects of heavier weapons and armor. Weapons mainly affected are Ochis and Odachi. Oh, it's not Orochi, it's Odachi. Skill, the amount of the amount required to activate the special effects of more technical weapons and armor. Weapons mainly affected, dual source, Talfana, and guns. Dexterity determines the effect of capacity of your ninjutsu. Weapons mainly affected. Kusavigama. Magic determines the effect and capacity of Onmyo magic. Spirit affects your guardian spirit. So I think starting off, second year you get 40 HP or 10 HP, but I do increase weapon damage by 1. I think I want body. Let's give me more life. But yeah, so you can only do one level at a time, and each level costs an increasing amount of Amrita, so I definitely gotta be careful. Alright. What do you have? Spirit man for himself. That looks like a... Oh, his head came off. Head came off. That's a pretty crazy stance. Should have run sooner. I wonder if every map you like... Nah, they probably wouldn't do that to you. They wouldn't make you like restart every map with like... base here. I love when you just run over these things. I'll kill the bastards myself. Oh Jesus, that's just so brutal. And you're swinging on him. Look at my, what about that? My does it tell us how much Amrita I have? I have 344 right now. I do need to start using the key pulse though. Oh, sacred water. There's something right here. Looks like something right there.
Yo, it's this way.
Oh, he goes automatically. Ooh, there's something over there. I don't know what that is, and I'm a little afraid. It's a revenant. Let's see if I can gain a level real quick before I face it. Let's also see if that shrine spirit gives me anything. The ability Receive Kodama Blessing has been unlocked. Jeez. Oh, Warrior Blessing increases armor rate drop by 1%. I guess the one that's already on is active. So if I wanted to switch, I would choose something else, huh? No. These other ones don't have anything. Sure, whatever. It's early in the game. It's not that important. I have enough on the level. More HP. I think I want more damage by a little bit. It's not that much more, but it's something. I think if it's like the other Souls-style games, I think it automatically saves. Like always, like every action you do is like saved already. So let me go try to kill this revenant over here. Come for you. Definitely part of it's gonna be you are defeated. Nice, nice. So they give me a weaker version of my boots. They put the boots back on. That sucks. I forget that when you go to the shrine, ooh, yeah, when you go back to the shrine, every enemy respawns. I just wanted to heal. Dang it. I'm gonna have to go heal again. So I run out to him and then I just like forget the buttons. I'm just gonna farm this guy over and over. That'd be horrible. Cause I don't get that much experience from him or whatever. And Rita, that weapon. Let's go ahead and equip it. Spies that thing above. Salt. Salt is used to purify a defilement. When used, it causes a large amount of ki damage to nearby yokai. That could be good. Sacred water. Water that has flowed through the inner sanctum of a shrine. It speeds up ki recovery for a short period of time. This water has been used in rituals since the days of old. I feel like this blue side should be like healing, while this orange side should be like damage based stuff. So stones and salt count as like damage. Yeah, these bandits stole everything. Oh. Wooden hammer. Oh yeah, I forgot about this guy down here. It's like stun lock almost. Yeah. If only had weapons, we could have fought back. Oh yeah. And those weapons are strong, but they're just so slow. Not worth using. Sucks that they haven't been dropping medicine, so don't really got a chance to heal right now. Remnant. Scarecrow. This is definitely giving me vibes of a Sekiro, but that's just how it is. Level 5. I don't think it's gonna be that much bigger of a difference or a challenge. Oh crap. Ooh. Haha. That was a little scary. Obtained 11 glory. It's scary because, like, I guess I'm not 100% sure what they're going to do. So the best thing I can do is just react. I should probably definitely get more key whenever I get the chance. I feel like I should definitely like switch to these other weapons. because they're a lot stronger, even though I chose particular weapons to be good with. Let me find a shrine. Well, that guy's just chilling right there, ready to ambush us. I see ya. Wow, there's two of these guys. That guy's just chilling right there too. Wow, they're all just chilling right there. I see you guys. I really don't want to use this medicine because I don't have much medicine. Because I have to go up there to come back down. Yeah, I do need to find a shrine if I can. I think I'm just gonna heal. It's too risky. So don't whiff in front of me, that's for sure. I feel like my style so far. Oh, my living weapon's actually ready to go. So that's a no way back type of thing. I guess the spirit weapon thing is in case, like, ouch. I'm so screwed. I'm gonna go all the way back and heal. Hopefully I can just like slide down this side of the cliff right here without dying. I don't know how much fall damage there is. That's pretty funny. Some more. I wanted more key, possible. Leave it stamina. Not stamina. Heart. I'll give you two key. Thing is, I really need to start. Ooh, that actually gives me +2 on my spear. I need to start doing key pulses. Pretty sure I can just sell some of this weaker stuff. It doesn't give me that much in Rita, but it's better than holding on to it and not having it give me anything, I think. Like this. It only gives me one. I don't know. I guess I'm like really hurting to level up and I just need like a little bit more Amrita, then I would sell whatever I have. I'm feeling putting on the high stance. I always forgot. I forgot about it. I keep mistiming the key pulse at this point. I already forgot about that guy that was in the house. Nice. Weaker spear. And we got some better pants. I have a feeling that one of these times I'm going to check one of these bodies and it's gonna be like an actual enemy. I wanna wait for these and use these at the actual shrine. Place signpost where you are and on your compass that indicates which way you need to go, imbued with power something something. So these are like way markers in case you get lost or something. There's an item up there. Read it. Yeah, so savage. I'm very glad I unlocked that. Alright, oh, what's the level of this guy? 6. I think I'm level 5, so it should be okay. Let me check something real quick. From behind. Oh, I can learn some of these. I have 5 skill points. Where are these? I like II or EI. Quick draw. Grasp power while keeping your sword in the scabbard for a quick draw and rapid strike. Only use when your sword is sheathed. So it's for sword, of course. Disperses key from your sword to stun surrounding enemies. While a limited weapon is active, hold Y to quickly slash at surrounding enemies. Follow up combo with a slash while stepping back. Oh, that might be good actually. Evasion. High stance only. Activates when you recover full key from a key pulse. Raises the damage caused by your next attack. Oh wow. I don't have enough of that, so don't worry about that. High stance only. I just probably learned this kick. Falls up combo with a kick that causes large amount of key damage. Yes, please. The skill's command is already assigned to a different skill. Do you want to override its this skill? Oh. Let me see something. I'm assuming I can change it to kick. Oh, so it's either this or wait. It's only with the sword. I think I kind of messed up there. Fatal fists. Bearing up attack plus 3. Oh, I super messed up. I didn't realize you have to cycle between the different weapons on top. Whoops. So I unlocked a bunch of things for the sword, but I did not unlock things for like the spear and stuff. It looks like some of these do carry over, but some of them are specific to the weapon. Okay, change my stance. Blah blah blah. What's this? High stance. Yeah, I definitely messed up. Okay. Now I know. Alright, so let me look at these guys first. Yeah, these guys are... this guy's weaker. Oh, that's cheap. Hella cheap. Need to find the next shrine though. So many dudes everywhere. I don't know if I don't want to fight that many dudes. Oh man. Falls in battle, his guardian spirit disperses and his Amrita coalesces into a grave. Should he touch it, the guardian spirit and Amrita will be restored to him. That sucks. I messed up. Try to get back to my spot as quick as possible. Sucks that I don't have anything that would like heal over time. Like heal my life over time, I mean. But it does look like I do have 3 elixirs regardless. So I wonder if I could keep my money, if I just lose my souls. Or in this case, we call it Amrita. Let's go up and get my Amrita. Very dangerous. Actually, that's a stronger dual sword. Maybe I should try the bronze hammer, just because it's hella strong. Oh, what? These are weaker, unfortunately. I feel like it's just... Woohoo! Shit. God damn it. I was getting mixed up by the different peoples. Like, one had low stamina, the other one had low life. I don't have a ranged weapon. I guess that's okay though. Pick up my body again. At least it's over here. Let's see here. feel like I gonna swing too much because there's a lot. A lot of times where they're in, like their stamina's gone, you can execute them using triangle. But I'm gonna be sitting here swinging too much, so I lose that prompt. I feel like I should just go for damage. Screwed. Oh, he's cheating. He's cheating. Gosh. So it does a lot of damage, but it's just so slow. So slow. Whoops. I did not mean to drink that. That's why you don't have stuff on. I feel like the hammer is like probably for slow enemies. I'm gonna skip that guy. I don't think he'll aggro on me, right? Also notice that on my bottom right shows me my money. I drunk that, whatever it was. It's supposed to speed up my speed my key recharge, but I still don't know how to really tackle this part. He did not die. He did not die either. Are they healing or something? Fuck! I'm so, like, impatient. It sucks because, again, I wonder if I just have to do high stance as well. So I think what's happening is that some of them are in high stance, and they can kind of armor through armor through the lower stances, probably, huh? That's probably part of the strategy, is be at a higher stance, and so when people try to swing at you quickly, again, you want to be at a higher stance to kind of hit them still. So you kind of like trade off damage for more damage, really. But it's hard when there's like a lot of them at once. Yeah, lows for fast, mids for like, it's like a trade-off between damage and speed, but high stance is like, it's slow, but you will interrupt them, is the thing. I have 4,000. I really need to, Sweet moves. Sweet moves, bro. See that I interrupted him because I am in my high stance at the time when he was about to swing. So yeah, maybe I should do medium stance for a little bit, but then switch to high once I need it. Many of y'all. Not like this guy. Aggro this guy over here. Oh, dang it. Scary. Alright. So yep, I learned a new tactic. You're supposed to, in the higher your stance, the more priority you have. At least, like, you can blow through lower stances. But I think high stance will knock you out, even if you are in high stance yourself. But I guess the trade-off is because it's a very slow wind-up. So you would have to somewhat preemptively do it, and hopefully they don't dodge out. But the dodging is not like, what's the word? So you can't cancel everything into dodge. It's not that good. Let's go ahead and switch to that. switch Bronze Hammer out. It's too slow, unfortunately. Let me try this. Orochi. Good reach. Hopefully there's a save point. Oh, I see, Yeah, I'm gonna find a shrine first before I go anywhere. At least I want to find a shrine. I don't know. Crap. Yay, finally a bow. Item up there, but I can't get up there. This. Not like this. I'd be really sad if I died in here. Ooh. Definitely heavy armor, probably. I'm not at max weight yet, so I'm still okay. Ten. So I need a shrine first. Where's one of these guys? Hopefully the shrine's not in here. That would suck. I feel like it is. I have no healing. Part of me wants to go back to the shrine. Wahaha! Was he stuck in? No, he's not. Fuck, not like this. Damn it. Crap. I didn't even cash in my points either. Oh man. I wonder if it's like Dark Souls, in which if you die twice, then you lose. You lose your Vita. Hopefully that's not the case. Because there's a high chance I'm about to die trying to go through that area again. Granted, I can just run through and grab my thing and try to run out. But again, that's just totally risky. I'm very slow because of this armor. Yeah, as much as I want to, it's probably better that I don't. I definitely want to use the heavy armor, but it's just kind of risky. Just wait to fight one guy by himself. We got some samurai man. I think I just lost all of my Emrita. My foot fell off. Damn it. Yep, just lost all of that. 5,000. Damn. That's very sad. That's what you get. It's that type of game though. Gotta be on point with everything. Everything's gonna die now. Gotta grind up my points. That's so crazy though. You did this to me. Reputation has increased. Wow. Yeah, I can't execute anybody. Because there's no invincibility during execution animation. That sucks. That sucks. Let's try using this thing. Slow. Yeah, his weapon's slow too. Man, I knew I should have went back and cashed in all my Emerita. I had like 5k. So I see in the bottom left there seems to be an icon that shows a 5, which is I think my samurai points. I'll grab this real quick. Ah, what? What you cheat for? God damn it. I'm really bad at this. Because it's not even like Bloodborne. Bloodborne is more fast paced. A lot easier to swing around your weapon. Titles. And you receive prestige points. You gain prestige points by spending prestige points. Or. Prestige bonuses by spending prestige points. After selecting one bonus, its entry on the list will be replaced, and then you can choose another. Increases luck to find items. How many spirits? I only have one Agayo prestige points. That might be useful. Yeah, useful. The yokai realm. Damage buff. Decreases the amount of received. Look at this. Between luck and yokai realm. Maybe the probability to find rare items might be very good. Yep, let's do it. Oh, interesting. And then it changes, so you don't get the same buff every time. Wow, there's so many things. Total key damage exceeds 75. Wow. 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 Reaper, slash the enemy with the Kusaraga Sickle. Press button repeatedly to vary the technique. I think it sounds pretty interesting. Kicks the enemy. I don't know how good that is for that situation, which I get swarmed by like two or three guys. I think I should probably go back to dual swords, actually. So I'm trying to, like, attack fast, but the Kusarigama is very slow. Chaining to a stance, blah blah blah. Follow up with a roundhouse kick. What's that roundhouse kick? What are these things? High stance only, a spinning attack that slices all around you. Wow. It sounds really good, but I know it used a bunch of key probably. This could be good actually. Let's go and get this first before I get the other one. Defense and thrust the sword while simultaneously guarding. Wait on that. Let's switch my second one back to the dual swords. There's a way to organize all these because there's just so many different ones. just by level. Level or power level? Or is that the same thing? I really want to at least make some progress tonight. Whether it be leveling myself up. Leveling myself up or at least opening up a new shrine. I hope it's the opening up a new shrine, but we'll see. I keep getting killed at this spot over here. Kind of annoying. But again, I just gotta get better at reading these enemies' attack patterns. It's a heavy one though. Yeah. I don't want heavy. How does I want heavy? Heavy's not good. Makes me slow as crap. Alright. Here goes nothing. I think I should start with this. Whoa, I don't know how I did not get hit by all that. I tried to key pulse to get some key, but yeah, press it too fast. That's definitely part of the challenge too, is delaying the key pulse so you gain back as much key as possible. Definitely need to just keep backing up. So I think what I keep doing is I keep fighting them all in that little kind of ridge area. I need to just bring them all the way back down here like I did the first time. Oh, what? I missed the impale. I have so many stones. But yeah, it's definitely counter hit damage, I have noticed that. It was like that in Bloodborne as well. If they interrupt you doing an action, then yeah, you just take heavy amounts of damage. So he's doing a low stance. Yeah. crap. Ooh. I dodged that somehow. Yeah, I don't know, sometimes with the so when the reticule turns red, you can actually crit strike him. But I always like miss the timing or something, because I just never get it. Definitely hate how hard it is just to kill like basic dudes, but again, part of it too is just the fact that I have low damage output right now, because I haven't really been leveling up my guy. I do have a lot of gold though, so I guess that's the cool thing about this game, where you don't only have one currency, just the Amrita, you actually have gold as well. So this time I have two heals, so I think I should be better off than I was last time. I didn't see there was a treasure chest last time. Not bad, not bad. What did we get here? Nothing good, unfortunately. Okay. This. Oh, it's cool that this kind of DLC helmet doesn't weigh anything. I don't think. Maybe? Maybe it does. Yeah, it does one. Yeah, it does. Well, I don't know what I'm thinking. I guess because it says H on this top one, but this one doesn't have anything, but. Oh well. Alright. Medium is nice. Medium's nice again, but there's not enough stats on that one. Ooh. Got some grenades here. I have a lot of grenades, actually. Let's actually get some grenades on my other thingabob. Travel amulet. Amulet based by, or blessed by the gods of safe travel. It is used to transport you safely back to the last shrine at which you prayed. These gods are often enshrined in stone monuments or statues on the outskirts of villages and are said to hold the power to divide the realms of human and yokai. This question is, do I want to chance it again and fight, or do I want to buy some upgrades here? I think I'm gonna be a man and fight this thing. Side, bro. Honestly, I should probably use my ultimate. Ouchies. Killed me. Woo-hoo. I'm living life on the edge right here. Aha! I achieved my way to victory. Is there a shrine? There's no shrine. Oh well. Actually, the shrine might be right outside here. This shrine better be out here, to be honest. Yep, I see it. It's over there. So I didn't fully explore the other side, so let me pray at this shrine real quick. Then I'm gonna go back. Great. Cool. Alright, level me up, please. Alright, so what do I want? Maybe some stamina, actually. Stamina. Skill? Yeah. Stamina and skill. These offerings. Actually, what about the boons? Oh, not the boons. It's the at least I don't need to change it, I should say. I haven't used my ultimate yet. I really should. Alright, so let's investigate the other way first before I move on. I see there's a spear right there, actually. Yo, it's this way. This way. Oh, that's a demon dude, looks like. Or yokai. Alright, now I'm gonna go back. Yeah, I wonder if it'll get to a point where, well, the gonna suck. Because I have to go through these guys again. Though I think coming from the back. So coming from the side, it's gonna make it a lot easier. So I can shoot him in the head here. Kill him. That's pretty sad. He did a crit, but he did kill him. He had a helmet. Die. That's so misleading. I love how I can just sidestep him. He already died, but I like sliced off his arm anyways. Alright. So it sucks that I wasn't able to, I guess, replenish my arrows. But that's fine. I wonder if, again, there's gonna be a shop where you can actually buy. Seems that one of these guys are missing, actually. I definitely do that all wrong. After the combo, I'm supposed to wait to key charge. Okay, after it's gonna be super annoying. Let's go this way. Scaring me a little bit. Thing is, like, because you go through there already, but he doesn't attack, but then all of a sudden you come back and he charges you. That is quite the BS. Fire amulet. let's go this way. Try not to get jumped by people with arrows. Oh. Another one of these guys. Shrine right here. Nice, nice. Go ahead and save edit. Or pray edit. Let's go ahead and level up again. What do I want now? Strength? Strength. Probably wants to just sell all these like low level stuff. But I think I'll just wait on that again. I have so many points, like samurai points and stuff, but I just don't use them. I do it. See ya, sucker! That's pretty funny. What if he's gonna come back up here? Alright, remember I reset everybody, so let's not get surprised by anything. Now I can fight this guy. Keep charging way too early. Alright. Let me get all this. Alright, let's try it out. Ah, press the wrong button. Yeah. Heavy. At least not strong enough to replace what I have already. I think this one's like quote unquote rarer or has like better specialness to it. So it says damage reduction status ailment suffered. Wait, what? This one's light. Yes, please. It's not like that much of a like change. It actually gives me more Amrita by a little bit. Well, this one, this is light. It makes your life. It's actually good right now too, because I'm fighting a lot of humans. Look like a skirt. It's hard to say, they're like very similar. Again, I'm not really fighting that much yokai, so I don't really need to switch to that. Ooh, accessory. I haven't used one yet. Unlimited Omnio. I don't know what that means. Fire amulet. Abuse your weapon. Oh, it's like fire paper. Again, this is a different kind of bomb, I think. I think this is a stronger version of that. Maybe weaker. Yeah, weaker. You can tell by the rarity, too. It's blue instead of yellow slash gold. Of course, I have all this Amrita stones. Right. Question is that it? Because it looks like this is a wall that I can't get past. Or maybe I could have, yeah, to the right here. Whoa. That was a little creepy at first, but maybe you can come back around. Ooh. Okay, I interrupted it. Sidewalk. More bombs. Izuku Mado Tsukumogami. Omni Tsukushimi no Kokoro Araba. Sono Umashido Kroe to Tsurish Tamae. I'm pretty sure. Oh, that's the beginning, isn't it? Before I go that way, I want to kill this remnant up here. I died here. What? That's high stain. Oh shit. Bob right here. Nice. Okay. I can just climb down instead of jump and possibly hurt myself. actually a shortcut to the beginning, it looks like. Nice. Alright. I've saved all the buddies. Let's see here. See a visitor. Pretty sure. I think it's better to do that. Ooh, it looks a drop rate. Kind of sucks you can't do like more than one, but I guess it's okay. Also, I see that it has like, it tells you how many of these Kodamas are in the area. Looks like I've saved 5 out of 9, so that's pretty nice. Let's see if I can't level up another. Yep, just enough to level up. One more key. Only not skill, but heart gives you some, but it's not that much. I wonder if like every spirit gives you a lot. Maybe I should get some spirit, because it looks like I'm starting to fight against like the yokai. Sure. So there's that. Now let's check my weapon skills. Let's see. Pretty much I'm still using the same weapons. Quick draw. I wonder if quick draw is probably good. Sign of the cross. Let's do it. All these other ones are like high stance. Activates when you fully recover key from key pulse. Raises damage by your next attack. Spin attack that selects all around you. I think I'm doing that. So it's mid stance combination, more incorporating defense and attack. Touch a sword while simultaneously guard. Really probably invest in some of these too. Slash enemy with the sickle. Press button directly to six times. Draws them close. We'll probably just use toward them if they're large. That actually might be good. I think I wanted something like that actually. It looks like a lot of these are, well, I guess there are multiple ones you could assign eventually down the road. I'm gonna get another, plus one key. That is really low, but then again, all these are low. Jutsu power. Maybe I should do this, how much HP gets restored. 0.5% is probably like 30 HP, give or take. Yeah, let's do it. Alright. Gotta get rid of all these. That. Alright. I think that is good for me for my first play of this.